Hi all, Hal here with more 7 Days to Die. And this is the late night edition. Oh, it is way too early or way too late in the day. I'm not sure which. It's the middle of the night for me on Thursday. So happy Friday. Yeah, actually it is Friday. So happy Friday, everybody. Hope you had a fantastic week. And I hope you're having a great weekend or, you know, setting up for a great weekend. So what we're going to be doing today is I actually need to get the motorcycle, well, the mini bike, out of the yard. Yeah, small situation, kind of funny, and we'll leave it at that. The thing we have been doing is I've been watching the spawner through the evening, and apparently we got a bit of a wandering horde out there. So the game actually spawns not just the wandering hordes, but you get a horde in the morning and a horde in the evening. Looks like the random wandering horde has been dealt with by itself. Wow. They destroyed the blocks. Okay. What's it look like over here? It's not too bad over here. So, yeah, we actually, it looks like we had a rather significant random horde, roaming horde, show up last night. Alright, so let's see here. Where's the motorcycle? Our motorcycle's over there. Or our mini bike, I should say. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna set up a bit of a ramp so that we can get out of here. Oh, that's rather easy, actually. Alright. And just because I don't really feel like dealing with trying to line up on some of the stuff. Oh, look at that. So yeah, basically what happened was is I jumped the bike up on the roof to get it into the courtyard, or onto the roof itself, and when I went to turn it around, I basically started to back up, wasn't paying attention, and it fell off into the courtyard. So, so what we're gonna do is basically just see if we can get everything to line up here. Alright, so now that we've got that lined up. And that should launch us pretty much out of the place. Okay. Let's give it a try. How am I bleeding out? Wow. All right. So, oh, that's not good. All right. Well, we found a great bug. So don't ride through the spikes on the mini bike. Because alright, so I think I'm gonna have to actually restart my game and see if that clears out the bug. What is All right. So why am I not able to hit you now? Apparently she knows the dodge. There we go. All right, so let's try this one more time really quickly, and if it doesn't work, then... Okay. That was rather random. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to head out and take a look up to the north a little bit, do a little bit of exploring today. So yeah, just remember, don't ride your mini bike through any of the spikes. That was kind of weird because it wasn't like it stopped, you know, completely. It actually got, when you got back on the bike, it started up again. So, fun stuff. Anyway, so yeah, hopefully everybody, like I said, been having a good week so far. Mine's been a little bit random. It's like, not bad. Ow, man, you just take damage for everything on the mini bike now. This is crazy. Oh, so I don't know if people have been paying attention. Apparently, a couple of the YouTubers have actually, let's take a look over here, have actually found some of the motorcycles, like some of the advancements for the motorcycle. One of them is the Hog. So you start with the mini bike, right? Mad Mole and company have said before that the mini bike is basically just the first iteration on the man, what is, there's nothing in this house, really? Yeah, but the mini bike is basically the first iteration on the mobility system in the game, right? So there's going to be an actual motorcycle that is the upgrade for the mini bike. That's the Hog. It's actually a really nice road bike. It's got some spikes on the front of it, you know, as well as, sorry, a little distracted here. Just not used to having any of the houses be this barren. This is rather crazy. Yeah. But yeah, so with the mini bike, you get the Hog upgrade, and then there's actually another thing that was put into the resources or in the asset files for Alpha 14, and it's a gyrocopter. Now, for those who don't know what a gyrocopter is, think Mad Max, the original Mad Max, with the guy on the little helicopter, the ultralight helicopter thing. Yeah, that would be what it would be. So it's basically an ultralight helicopter. It's got a small push motor on it. So at some point, there's a potential we're going to have the ability to actually fly in the game outside of, you know, bugs launching us across the world. So... And we got a little zombie over here. Which one are you? Oh, you one of them. Oh. Sorry, Timmy. Had to put her down. Alright, so where'd our mini bike go? Oh, there it is. I was gonna say, you don't want to lose that. Alright. Bird nest. Yay, bird nest. Okay. Off we go. So basically what we're out looking for is anything that we can use at this point. We are coming up on day 14 already. And I wanted to just head out a little bit, see what's out and about. I really should be stopping killing the deer, because there's a bunch of them. We got 3 deer in this close area. How did I miss that? Ah. Man, my aim is just crap today. This is why I don't play in the middle of the night normally. Alright. I don't even have a knife with me. Chop him up. So yeah, I'm really interested to see what's going to be going on in the near future. Because with all of the changes that Mad Mole and the Fun Pimps have been putting into the game, there is a lot of really good stuff on the horizon. Alright, so she's dead. Let's go. Need to put the meats in the motorcycle there. Oh, new character model. Alright. Did you bring me anything useful? No, of course not. So yeah, and like I said, the rotocopter thing hasn't even been announced. It was just found pretty much by chance. For those who may know him, and I've got a link to him on my channel, you might want to go check out Mafke's video on it. I believe he just released it today. Well, for y'all, it'll be Thursday. It would have been Thursday, but maybe he's letting it out today. I don't know, but definitely something to check out if you're interested in to see what's going on. He's basically looking through what's in the game files, and he did a little preview of it, just showing you the differences between all of the different vehicles. Again, the model graphics are in, but the item model is not, if that makes sense. Basically, I think he had to do a graphic swap for the hog, at least. So it's using, I think he said he's using one of the obsolete car models, but basically so he could actually get the graphic in there, he had to put it on a different system. But you get to see the whole thing. It looks really interesting. If you haven't seen it, definitely check it out. Like I said, I should have a link to Mafke's channel over up on my my channel. If not, let me know and I'll throw you a link for the video itself if he publishes the video. Come on. All right. Okay, so we're going to continue north. Oh wait, that straightened out, so that means there's probably something over here. Looks like we might be coming up on a town, actually. What I'm really wanting to find is the oil shale. But I never have luck when it comes to that stuff, so... diverging biome. Oh, that's a farm. Farms are always interesting. It's like, of all the things to leave in the car, aspirin is not what I was expecting. I'm sorry, pain relievers. May as well just go ahead and take these things apart and get the fuel out of them at least. Hey, you never know, we might actually get lucky and get something else too. I love when we get fuel though. Wow, they really increase the fuel that you get out of these things now. That's a whole lot of fuel. Okay, now, when I started, I had no fuel in my inventory, right? I just got 172 fuel out of this thing. Alright, let's go back and take that one apart as well, since we're here. The full cars we usually get, you know, an engine out of. So maybe we'll get a motor or a battery or something.
If we get really lucky, we'll get both. Do I have any room in inventory? Yeah. Just had to make sure I still had room in inventory. Oh, you know what? You, my good friend, are gonna scrap down. Okay. There we go. Look at all this good stuff. Wow, you get a lot of fuel out of these things now. Okay. So, but hey, we did get a motor. Nice. So we got almost, well, you figure we averaged 170, so it was 340. Not bad. So about a third of a tank of gas, which means we are now a little over half a tank. So I may have to start stopping for the all of the wrecked cars. Let's see what we got down here. Because we did pass a lot of cars. Look at all these guys. Can we get fuel from you? Yep. Okay, so there is a reason to stop and pick up all of the roadside wrecks now. Oh. Nice. Okay, so first things first, let's go ahead and put some of this stuff in the car, or in the car, in the bike here. Oh, nice. So it automatically updated for me, huh? And put you away. We have anything in here that we have more of in there? Let's scrap you. Scrap you. Hey, we can scrap it. Nice. All right. Let's go ahead and put that in there. Put some cloth in there. And now we have room in our inventory to continue looting. Oop. Okay. Nice and easy. It's really bad that, you know, the entirety of my existence in this game is now looking for gasoline. So I did have a couple of people asking about the recent changes to the fuel system in the game. For those who don't know, it takes approximately 1,000 gas to fill up your tank now. And my thought on it is that they're probably measuring it in a different volume and didn't scale things appropriately. So one of the people, what happened to all my fuel? Where'd all my gas go? Oh, so you swap the engine and it gives you all your gas back. So yeah, there's 3/4 of a tank of gas right there. They're right. And that was what, 1200, roughly 1200 fuel? So yeah, it takes a ridiculous amount of gas now for these things. And I think it may depend on what engine you're using. The better the engine, the least fuel or the less fuel it takes. So a 600 quality perfect engine would probably be like, say, 1500 gas to completely fill up your tank. Okay, so one more. Man, it's nice to have all these empty cars out here. Let's see what we got going on. Do we get lucky and get another motor? Doesn't look like it. Of course, I didn't see us pick up the last one, so you never know. So much gas. Good stuff, good stuff. Now if I could actually make a wrench, that would be really helpful. Okay. Yep, got a battery though. Is that better than the one I have? No. Nope, definitely not. Okay. So, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call this one here. Basically, all I'm going to end up doing is the same thing I've been doing, which is taking these cars apart, and then I'm going to start heading home, and so we'll see if we can get something going on for this weekend. So thank you all for stopping in today. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it was kind of a casual episode. Not a whole lot except for the normal zombie killing and doing a little bit of looting. And missing the zombies horribly. How do I miss a fat zombie? Wait until you see the reds of their eyes. Alright. So, anyway. We've got more deer out here. We got all sorts of stuff. I think I'm going to be out here for a little bit. Alright, so thank you all again for stopping in. If you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments, you know the drill. Throw it down in the section below the video, and I will do my best to get back to you in a timely manner. If I don't make it, I apologize. It just means I ran out of time. And I am out of time, so I hope you all have a fantastic day. Don't forget, we do have the live stream tonight at 7 p.m. U.S. Pacific time. Hope to see you there. If not, I hope you have a fantastic weekend, and we'll see you next time. As always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. Oh, so much fun taking cars apart. Anything good? Oh, look at that. Give me a wrench. Give me a wrench. Come on. Oh, lead weights. Oh, well. Thank you.